mobility, and also the difficulty level should be adjusted.
For example, here we have this short video of the patient that is kneeling on the balance board and playing. She is bending to the right and left, and she is driving this the car. This is one of the games that is available in the game.reha.lviv.ua gaming session. What's very important is that all the information about the results of the game is stored on the web server, and the physical therapist could see the progress of his patients. He can see who played which game, how long, and with which score. And it gives the possibility to supervise the home training. Also, what's important, the games are not just for training, but there are some evaluation tools incorporated. For example, using this balance board, our people have developed such an equivalent of stabilometry tool. So the patient has to stand for 15 seconds with eyes closed, and the displacement of the center of pressure is measured, and several parameters are calculated. The games can be played in different positions, while standing, kneeling, or sitting on the balance board. One more approach is games with the dance mat. Dance mat is very easy to install hardware. It's approximately 1 meter by 1 meter such a mat that have nine active sensors. And the games are played by stepping on the appropriate sensor. And here have now a video, so you'll have a better idea how it's working. This is this dance mat. And what's very important, the games have possibility to individually adjust the difficulty. So we have, for example, in this game, you have to step on the appropriate sector to catch the butterfly hit the mole. And we can adjust how long this mole would be waiting. We can adjust how many moles are at the time appearing and other parameters. This is a short video demonstrating the game that is played with the Microsoft Kinect sensor. So the sensor is able to track the movement without attaching any markers. So this boy is playing the game with his right hand. There are games that could be played by the hands, and we have also the games that can be played by the tongue movements. So we have to bend to right or left, and left to guide the game. I'll be quicker. One more post, it's augmented reality, so the patient is used in the gaming. Also, we have participated in several research projects. One is game enabling project of the seventh framework program, and currently we are participating in the Gable project. It's aimed at developing of the social platform for game. Okay, so the children are not just playing, but also communicating with others. And what's very important, our gaming services are open for all the patients. They can use them for free. Thank you for attention, and now I'll give the floor to the next speaker. He'll tell about the bonus plasticity.
Good morning, dear colleagues. I'm going to talk about spasticity because that's a symptom that we see in our children most frequently. According to the surveillance of Cerebral Palsy in Europe, spasticity occurs in up to 85% of children with cerebral palsy. We have a lot of definitions of spasticity, but in our opinion, the most accurate one is the definition by Lance, who said that spasticity is a motor disorder characterized by velocity-dependent increase in tonic stride reflex. In spastic forms of cerebral palsy, it is crucial to differentiate the two key components that characterize the change of the muscle tone. First, it's the change in mechanoelastic properties of muscle and connective tissue. And second, the tonic stretch reflexes increase. Spasticity is relatively easy to diagnose, but not that easy to measure quantitatively. So to tackle that problem, the Swedish company Geremedtech, in association with the research team from Karolinska Institute, developed a device called a neuroflexor. The neuroflexor works by measuring the resistance to passive motions of the limb performed with different velocity. For instance, on the video, we see one session of measuring spasticity, and that's the fast movement. Before we saw that the slow movement. Typically, one session consists of 10 slow movements and 5 fast movements. The neuroflexor allows us to differentiate and quantitatively measure the different components comprising the muscle tone, such as elastic, viscous, and neural component, which is the equivalent of spasticity. And now the most important part of the report, our research on spasticity and the effects on it of our system. So as you know, we treat children according to the intensive neurophysiological rehabilitation system, the central component of which is the spine manipulation by the original method of Dr. Kozyavkin. In the beginning of the 2000s, we analyzed cases of over 10,000 patients, and revealed that after treatment course, spasticity decreases in 94% of cases. That study had some methodological limitations, but still allowed us to hypothesize that it is a spinal manipulation that causes a decrease in spasticity. So to further study the relationship between between reduction of spasticity and spinal manipulation, we started a case study, case series, which consisted of 29 case studies. And the spasticity was measured before rehabilitation, after one single manipulation, and in the end of a two-week treatment course. What we revealed was that spasticity decreased already after one manipulation, and continued to decrease towards the end of the treatment. And we had our study published in the December 2016 issue of the Journal of Chiropractic Medicine. Our next step was to prove the causal relationship of spinal manipulation and reduction of spasticity. So for that reason, we performed a randomized controlled trial where we enrolled 78 children with spastic forms of cerebral palsy, age 8 to 18, and with low levels of spasticity, according to the max. So after baseline examination, patients were randomized into the experimental and control group. And the second examination was performed straight after the manipulation. The examination consists of a neurological examination and spasticity measurement with the aforementioned neuroplastic device. In the experimental group, the intervention was the spinal manipulation by Dr. Kozyavkin method. And in the control group, we did imitation of spinal manipulation, which was visually closely resembled spinal manipulation. So, as a result, In the experimental group, we observed clinical and statistically significant decrease in spasticity, while in the control group, the reduction was much more subtle and not clinically significant. So which leads us to the conclusion that it is a spinal manipulation that decreases spasticity in the forearm muscles in patients with cerebral palsy. Thank you.
Так, Валентина Николаевна, я думаю, що всі наші програми, ми дуже багато думали, як дати таку концентровану інформацію для вас. І на сьогоднішній день ви знаєте, що невеличка перший пілот проєкт, який працює разом з кимось групою. І на сьогоднішній день робимо пряме включення із Абу-Дабі, з Аляйна, із центра, в якому сьогодні приймають хворих. Ми попросили наших колег, вони підготували для нас інформацію для резюме.
So we thought on how to represent the joint work along the forest. Along with Cambridge Medical Rehabilitation Hospital and from our workers, from our staff in Alain, it would be the best option to represent by online Skype meeting from them currently working with the center.
Я думаю, що це буде цікаво для вас. Ви недавно там були, вернулися. Тобі буде сюрприз почути про те, що ми робимо разом з нашими колегами, з китаями. Цікаво, я думаю, що робота. По результатам зараз вам зроблять інформацію.
Many of you have just returned or came from Allen Center. So it will be like a surprise for you to see what's going on there, what is happening, and we'll speak on the results of treatment, about treatment outcomes.
Як вам відомо, частина колег проходить на стажування, і на сьогоднішній день доктор Нікас, який веде групу, там присутні наблюдателі наші і так далі, і так далі.
Yes, currently there's present Dr. Nikas, who underwent a full educational course